Hello, today I'm here with my fourth favorite video, and today we are going to talk about eyeshadow palettes. And I just quickly wanted to mention some brushes because I have discovered some new brushes this year. So this video is going to be about my favorite eyeshadow palettes and eyeshadow brushes, and I think we will start with the brushes. If you don't want to see the brush things, you can skip to this time. My favorite eyeshadow brushes for 2018 has been partly these two. These are Linda Hallberg's 304, is this one, the bigger one, and 303, the small one. I love these brushes. These are my absolute favorite brushes I have ever used. I can really recommend these. I love the look of these and I love how they are working, and they are so good. Then I have found a new favorite blending brush, and I think I have bought like four of these, and it's the BH Cosmetics V5. So it's their vegan brushes, and V5, I don't know if it's number 5 in their vegan line or not, but these are called V5, and this is a big, fluffy, super cheap vegan brush. And then I also found this one. This is the Faux Blue B04 from Real Techniques, and this is pointy little one. I usually don't like the small blending brushes, but this one I really really love. And then also the last one is from Sigma, and it's this one. This is E45. I bought this in November, I think, and I've used it like every time that I have done my makeup since I bought it. And it's the small tapered brush, and I use this underneath my lower lash line, and I love this so much. So we just hop into the palettes now, and I will start with some boring ones and then go into the more fun things. So I have 6 palettes to talk about, and we will start with my favorite single eyeshadows. So this is maybe not the palette, but I have them in the palette, and that is of course Nabla's single shadows. I have mostly tried a matte one. I have one shimmer one, but Nabla's single shadows are amazing. I love the Soul Blooming palette as well, but these are so good. These are some of the best matte neutral eyeshadows I have ever tried, and this has been a big favorite this year. I bought these when they came out, and I love them. I can really recommend them, and I think I want to buy more of the single shadows from Nabla because they are so good. And then I also took a palette. I've tried to do categories for this, but I'm not so good at that, so maybe don't use them. This is the best multifunctional eye and face palette, like the longest category ever, and it is of course the Linda Hallberg Infinity palette. I love this so much, and in the beginning of the year I used it mostly for my eyes, but now I almost use it I always use it for my face now, and I use Maffei, this super light shade, as my contour. So now you know how pale I am. And this Milky Way. Sometimes I use one of these blushes, but this Maffei and this Milky Way, they are like heaven. So this is my best multifunctional palette of 2018. And then we will go into my favorite neutral palette of 2018, and that has been Soft Glam by Anastasia Beverly Hills. And this was my third palette from Anastasia, but this was the first one with this formula. If you don't know that about Anastasia Beverly Hills, the Subculture and Prism, they are pretty similar. They are a little bit drier, maybe a little bit harder to work with, but the Soft Glam and Modern Renaissance, they are super creamy, super easy to blend, super easy to work with. I think they would work for anybody. So this, I bought this before the Modern Renaissance, and I fell in love with this palette like the first time I tried it, and it looks like this. And I really, really love this one. The shimmer shades are so soft, and they stick to your eyes without glitter glue, and I love that. And also, I love the colors of this. I love the orange shoulder and burnt orange the most, and also mulberry if I wanted to deep down my eye look a little bit. And this bronze is so, so nice. I really, really, really love this palette. I am so glad I bought it. And if you want to buy one palette from Anastasia and you don't know which one, and you want like a good palette that you can use a lot, I would recommend the Soft Glam. I have three palettes left to talk about, and these are of course the colorful palettes. And 2018 has been the year when I have discovered colorful makeup looks. I didn't use it before because I didn't think it suited me, and now it's like the only thing I do. So yeah, now I'm going to show you my three top palettes, and I have done some categories for these as well. So we can start with the Underdog, and I hope this is going to be right. It should be Underdog. So my Underdog palette from 2018. I think I could put up a little like counting thing every time I say 2018 in this video, because it is a lot. So the Underdog has been the Hasina 2 palette, and this palette is nothing. This doesn't contain anything that I really, really love, because blue, purple and green is not my favorite. But I bought this one after seeing a lot of reviews, and I am so glad that I changed my mind. I really love this palette. I have used it today. I have used Mohan. It's the purple one, of course. And I really, really love this palette. I am so glad that I changed my mind. This is one of the things that I am most happy about that I changed my mind about. So this is my Underdog palette for 2018. Then the biggest surprise of this year was the Creepy Cute from Strobe. And pastels, I think it's never have been my thing. And the palette looks like this. I have used this so much. I have used Take a Hint today. It's in my inner corner. But I don't have to tell you because you can see it. And this, I have gotten so much use out of this, even though it's only 8 shadows, and 2 of them are not colorful shadows. I have really loved this palette. I am so glad that I bought it. It's vegan, and it is an amazing palette. I am so happy that I have it in my collection. It's the only pastel palette I have, and I really love it. These colors are so creamy. They go so good together with like themselves and everything else. I really love this palette. I can really recommend these. The only thing, it's pretty expensive to get it to Sweden. I think the shipping is almost the cost of the palette, but I really, really love this one. And now we're down to the last palette, and this has been such a hard video to make because I have a lot of eyeshadow palettes. I have a lot of eyeshadow palettes I love, and then to narrow it down to 6, that was very, very hard. And for this category, I didn't come up with a good name. First I was like the little extra, or the thing that got me into color, or I don't know. I didn't come up with a category for this one. This was the first super colorful palette I bought, and this is one that I love the most. It has a special place in my heart, and it's the Suwulu by Yuga's Place. This is a 9 pan palette. It looks like this, and I really love this one. I love it so much. I have used this yellow today. This is a pretty dark yellow. It's not a bright yellow, but It is a really, really nice yellow. I really, really love it. I don't want the brown in this palette. I would wanted something else, maybe a red. That have been, because I think these three colors are like the same family, and these three are the same family, and here it should be red. And US are really good at red, but this palette, I love it even though I don't like the brown in this. If you don't have this and you like color, you need to buy it. You need to buy it, but it is an amazing palette. And this palette made me fall in love with Juvia's Place and also made me fall in love with colors. So it has a place in this 2008 favorites. And then for a little bit extra, I was thinking about taking the brand, a new brand that I really love when it comes to eyeshadows. And this brand, it's an indie brand, and I have bought a lot of palettes from them, and I really like all the palettes I have tried, because I haven't tried them all yet, and it is of course Blush Tribe. So yeah, I have 6 palettes, and I have the Hasina that we have already talked about, and then I have the Hasina 2, and then the Hasina palette. I haven't tried this yet. I got this last week, so I haven't tried it yet, but it will come videos on this one. And then we have the Blossom palette. This is a beautiful rainbow palette, all matte. And then the Munasa palette, I haven't tried this either. It will come videos on this as well. And the Paulina palette, love this palette, such a good palette. It will come in 3 looks, 1 palette on that one. I'm working on it. I have done 1 or 2 looks, maybe just 1 look. I think it's just 1 look, but it will come. And also the Fall Fuchsia palette. And this was close to be in my favorite videos, but it didn't make a cut. But this one, I really love it. So it feels like this was a messy video. I have sometimes hard to like stick to one thing to talk about. I always blabbering away. So this was 6 of my absolute favorite palettes of this year. I couldn't decide for only 1 or 2 palettes. It is impossible, because I've tried so many new palettes this year, and even to choose 6 of them were so hard. So I really hope you liked this video, and I really hope you liked this week when I only did favorites. So that was all for this video. I really hope you liked it, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do, so you don't miss any of my videos, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!